Hello friends, welcome back to my blog. Today I'm sharing the most requested gulab jamun recipe and I'm preparing it from scratch using milk powder and not from the instant pack. The ingredients that I need I'll be sharing now, and it is around 100 grams of milk powder that I'll be using. The brand that I used is this one. So for 100 grams of milk powder I need around 25 grams of whole wheat flour, around 3 to 4 grams of baking powder, pinch of salt, around 5 tablespoons of melted homemade ghee, around 50 ml of milk. It's always double the amount of the milk powder that you take. So these ingredients what I just explained will be used to prepare the dough, and that will be later fried. To fry you can use any vegetable oil. I'm using this. Then moving to the sugar syrup. Actually these fried balls are popped into the sugar syrup, and to prepare the sugar syrup the following ingredients are required: around 500 grams of brown sugar, around 500 ml of water, around half a teaspoon of cardamom powder, few saffron strands, rose essence, around a teaspoon. Gulab jamun, it is actually a mixture of two words, gulab and jamun. Gulab means rose, so the importance of rose essence you can see from the name of the dessert itself. And they are actually soft melt in mouth fried balls which are then dunked into sugar syrup. So let's start with the recipe. So let's begin. I'm taking 100 grams of milk powder. Now we are preparing the dough actually. Now I'm adding 25 grams of this whole wheat flour also here. I would add now the baking powder. We will add a pinch of salt, not more. Now I will add the homemade ghee into this and will make a crumbly mixture. I'll explain and summarize the ingredients that I have used. Around 100 grams of milk powder, 25 grams of whole wheat flour, 3 to 4 grams of baking powder, pinch of salt, and 5 tablespoons of melted homemade ghee. Now we will mix these ingredients and prepare a crumbly mixture. I have been mixing all the ingredients together to form this crumbly mixture. This mixture should look something like this. When you take it in your fist and press, and just press it like this, it should fall apart like this. Now we will prepare the dough by adding milk. The key thing in the right gulab jamun is actually the dough and also the temperature at which you fry the jamun balls. So let's see how the dough should look like. You should be very careful while adding milk. Don't add everything at once. Keep adding little by little. But keep in mind that you don't knead this dough, but you just add milk and bring them together. Kneading will create gluten, which we don't want. I keep adding little by little milk to make this dough. Be very careful, don't add the entire milk at once, because we never know, it all depends on the quality of the whole wheat flour. and the milk powder, so be very careful. You should be making a smooth dough actually, but don't knead it, just get all the mixture together. Don't worry about the messy dough that is formed here. I think we will be now applying a bit of oil here and allowing it to rest for around 10 minutes. And in the meantime, we will prepare our sugar syrup, and also we will prepare our oil. So I have kept the dough here closed. We will allow it to rest 10 minutes, as I said. Now we will start with making sugar syrup. Add 500 grams of sugar. Now I will add around 500 ml of water. Allow it to cook. We don't need any string consistency of the sugar syrup. We just need to melt the sugar and then add all the spices and the essence, what I told. As you see, I have started preparing the sugar solution. It has been around 10 minutes now. I will cook further. And in the meantime, we will start preparing the balls for jamun. Let's see what the status is after 10 minutes. I see it is a bit dried out, but we can fix it by adding a bit of milk. Added milk and made the dough a bit soft. Now we will start preparing the balls, and to prepare the ball we will slightly grease our palms with ghee, and now I will take a small portion of the dough, and in between our palms we will be rolling it into a ball. It should be very smooth. We should get a smooth ball like this. Ensure that there are no cracks. We will not prepare all the balls at once, as I said. We will be preparing some 7 to 8 at a time, and then we will be frying it. So keep the balls ready like this, and now we will prepare our oil also. So to fry the ball, I have added oil here. Always ensure that you have sufficient amount of oil. If you have less oil, the balls will not get fried in all the sides properly. We will allow it to get heated. In the meantime, we will check the sugar syrup. The sugar is fully melted, and now we will add the cardamom powder and the saffron strands. So here goes the cardamom powder. Now we will add few saffron strands. I always love lot of saffron in the gulab jamun, so around 20 to 25 strands should be good. Now we will add the rose essence. I'm adding a teaspoon of this. So the oil has been heating. It should not be too hot, as well as it should not be too cold. The right temperature is always essential for preparing the right gulab jamuns. I will be now adding the balls into this, and we will fry. I will show you how we fry it also to ensure that it is cooked on all sides well. So the oil has been heating and now we will add these balls which we have prepared. So I add one by one, ensure that you don't break it. I'll be adding them carefully. Important thing is you just keep swirling this oil so that they don't stick to the bottom, as well as they will be rolling inside and cooking on all sides. Once you have dropped the gulab jamuns, you can slightly increase the temperature, but still make sure that it is not too hot. Slightly increase and keep swirling in the oil so that they get fried well. And due to the addition of baking powder, they will be slowly bulging in size. Don't touch the balls, just keep swirling the oil. That way they will be cooked on all sides. As you see, they are turning slowly golden brown. We should fry, keep frying, as I said, swirling the oil. And you can actually fry till deep brown color or a bit golden color, it's all your wish, but always keep rotating like this. So temperature is the key here, temperature as well as the smoothness of the ball. If the ball is cracked, you will get the fried ball cracked. We don't want that actually. So while preparing the balls as well as while frying, we should be very careful with regard to this gulab jamuns. So I have been frying for around 3-4 minutes now. The temperature is, as said, not neither too high nor too low. If it is too low also, it will start cracking. And if it is too high, you will see dark color soon outside, but it will not be cooked well inside. So as said, be very careful with regard to the temperature. And another thing to note is never overcrowd your frying pan with the balls. So around 8 to 10, not more than that, you should be frying at a time. Also, as I said, never keep the balls, all the balls ready at a time, because they will be drying out. Only make as many balls as you need to fry for the next batch. So this is the right color that I'm looking for. So I'll be removing them now from the oil. As you see, they are all cooked on all sides and I will be placing them on a tissue paper. Now that we are done with frying, I have got around 28 balls. They are warm enough now, and at this point I'll be transferring them to the warm sugar syrup. If the sugar syrup had cooled down, you can slightly warm it up, but not boiling it, I meant, just warm it up and transfer them. So I have transferred all the fried jamun balls to the sugar syrup. As you see, it is warm enough, and I think I will be allowing it to stay in this sugar syrup for around 1 to 2 hours, and then it should be ready to serve. Now I would like to show you as how it looks from within.